Hi class, today we're going to take a look at our general factoring strategy. We've taken a look at all of the parts necessary in order to apply this strategy to any problem that you see in the chapter on factoring. Now, we've broken this down into two questions. The first question is there something in common? We always want to ask that first. After that, we ask ourselves how many terms, and how many terms will direct us to where to go next. There's either going to be two terms, three terms, or four terms, and how many terms there are will determine what we're going to do after we've factored out anything that's in common. Now, let's take a look at a couple of problems and apply these two questions. And these problems will be problems that you could see anywhere in your chapter, in any section. And you're going to approach them all exactly the same way by asking these two questions. Our first item we're going to deal with is going to be 3x squared plus 3x minus 18. Now, the first thing we want to ask is our first question. Is there something in common? And I notice when I look at all of the values that we have here for our numbers that 3 divides evenly into all of them. So the first thing we want to do is factor out that 3. Factoring out that 3, we're left with x squared plus 1x minus 6. Now we examine what's left in our parentheses here. And what's left in this parentheses here has 3 terms. So since there's 3 terms, we need to determine if a is 1 or if a is not 1 to decide what we do next. And I notice that a is 1 right here, so that means we can use our shortcut. So our shortcut, if you'll remember, asks yourself, what multiplies to get the c, and our value for c over here is negative 6, and at the same time adds up to b, and our b right here is 1. So we want to think about what we multiply to get negative 6. And negative 6 can be 1 times negative 6, which would have given us a negative 5 if we added them. Or we could have negative 1 times a positive 6, which would give us a 5 if we added them. So neither of those work. And then we could have 2 times negative 3 or negative 2 times positive 3. Notice that these two here, the 2 and the negative 3, when you multiply them, you get the negative 6. When you add them, you get a negative 1. Now, if you look at your middle term here, we want a positive 1. So let's take a look at the other pair that's like that, this one here. This one here is going to get the star because that one, when you add them, ends up being 1. So negative 2 times positive 3 is a negative 6, and negative 2 plus a positive 3 is our 1 in the middle. So that means that we can factor our 3-term polynomial into x minus 2 times x plus 3. And you always want to make sure you carry down your greatest common factor if you had one. So these two questions guided us through this particular problem. Let's take a look at another one that's going to be a little bit different. So the next one we look at is going to be 8w cubed plus 27. Now we always want to ask our first question, even though sometimes we can't use it. So our first question is there anything in common? And I notice that between the 8w cubed and the 27, nothing divides evenly into either of those. So even though our answer is no on this first question, we still want to check it. So now we go to our second question of how many terms? And there are 2 terms. So remember, if there's 2 terms, you need to check to see if you have a difference of squares or if you have a sum or difference of cubes. And I notice that if we look at our 8w cubed, that's 2w times 2w times 2w. So that's a cube. So let's check our 27. And 27 is 3 times 3 times 3. So that is also a cube. So that means that this is the sum of cubes pattern, because we have a plus in between our two terms. And if you'll remember, our sum of cubes pattern said that we wanted to make two parentheses to factor this. And the process we went through was to create our first parentheses from the actual problem. The cube root of our first item would be our first thing here. The cube root of the second would be the second item in our first parentheses. And whatever the sign was in our problem, we would carry down. And then if you'll remember, we would square this first item for the first thing that we have here. And then we would square the second item for the very last thing. And since when you multiply something by itself, it's always positive, this would be a plus, and then that second item squared. And then for our middle term in our second parentheses, we multiplied these two together. And that gave us an x, y. And finally, if this was a plus, we needed to make this one opposite, which is a minus. So if we had a minus and then a plus, that would be a difference of squares, and a plus and then a minus was the sum of, difference of cubes, and a plus and then a minus would be a sum of cubes. So now, all we need to do is follow this pattern with our problem. So let's make our two parentheses. We're going to use our 2w, we're going to carry the plus down, and we're going to use our 3 for our first parenthesis. And then we're going to square 2w. 2w times 2w is 4w squared for our first spot. Then we're going to square our 3 for our last spot, and 3 times 3 is positive 9. Now we need to make our middle term. To get our middle term, we multiply these two together, and 2w times 3 is 6w. And finally, since this is a plus, we need to make this other one a minus. And that is this particular problem factored. Let's take a look at another problem. Our next problem is going to be this particular one. We're going to have 2x plus 2y minus wx minus wy. Now, we always ask our first question, is there something in common? And if we look at all four terms, there's nothing in common with all four terms. But if we paired some terms up, there might be something in common with them. So instead of factoring out a common factor for the entire polynomial, what we're going to do is notice that there's four terms here. And when there's four terms, we do the process called factoring by grouping. So we're going to go ahead and first make this plus a negative wx so that we can actually group these last two here together and these first two here together. Now, if we look at just the first two, notice they both have 2 in common. So let's factor that out. And, once we factor that out, we need to look at what's left in our parentheses. And what's left is x plus y. Now let's go to our second parentheses and see what's in common with them. And I notice they both have a w, and they're both negative. So how about if we factor out a negative w? What that's going to do for us is change them both to positive, and when we change them both to positive, they will match what we have in the first parenthesis over here. So we're now going to go ahead and factor out a negative w out of this item, which is going to leave a positive x, and then a negative w out of the last item, which is going to leave a positive y. Notice now that our parentheses match. This is a x plus y, and this is also an x plus y. So we can treat this as one large term, and this is one large term, and factor out what's in common. And what's in common is they both have an x plus y. Now, what's left in our first item right here is just the 2 out front, and what's left in our second item is just the minus w. And this is our problem factored. We're going to take a look at 2 more. Let's take a look at this next one, and we'll leave the hard one for our last item. So for this next one, we're going to factor 4x squared minus 100. Now, many of you are probably looking at that and saying, oh, wow, it's a difference of squares, because I have a perfect square right here of 4x squared, and 100 is also a perfect square. So I can use my difference of square pattern. Well, you're on the right track. However, you need to make sure that you always ask yourself this first question of, is there anything in common? And if you look at our two terms in this problem, 4 divides evenly into all of them. So we need to factor that 4 out before we jump into our difference of square pattern. So let's factor out our 4. That's going to leave us with an x squared as our first item and 25 as our second item. It is a difference of squares now, but it's a much smaller, easier difference of squares, because notice that this now is going to be x times x, and this is going to be 5 times 5, which are much smaller numbers. So our difference of squares pattern, just to remind you, is if you have something squared minus something else squared, that's going to factor into the first item square rooted plus the second item square rooted times the square root of the first item minus the square root of the second item. So since the first square root of the first item here of x squared is x times x, we're going to have an x and an x. And since the square root of the second item is 5, it's going to be plus 5 and minus 5. And again, the order doesn't matter, but you do need to carry down your greatest common factor of 4. And that is our factored form for this. Now let's take a look at one more problem where we use this two-question process to guide ourselves through. This next problem is going to be 3x squared y plus 10xy plus 3y. Make sure you always ask yourself the first question of, is there something in common? And I notice that everything in this particular problem has a y. So let's factor a y out. Now I also notice that I'm not going to end up with a 1 as my leading coefficient here, and I'm going to have 1, 2, and 3 terms. So whenever I'm not going to end up with 1 as my leading coefficient, when I factor something else out, I like to use square brackets rather than parentheses to separate my greatest common factor. The reason why is it just makes it easier to organize your problem and keep track of everything. So we're going to use square brackets, and what's left after we factor out the y is a 3x squared plus 10x plus 3. Now we're going to factor using our process that we had called the AC method for factoring things where your A is not 1 and you have 3 terms. So the first thing we want to do is we want to multiply our A and our C, and A is 3 and C is also 3. So off to the side we're going to do 3 times 3, which happens to be 9. Now we're going to look at the factors of this 9 and try and come up with 2 factors that will multiply to get, or add up to get the 10, and at the same time multiply to get the 9. And I notice right off the bat that 1 times 9 is 9, and 1 plus 9 is also our 10 here. So we're going to take and split this 10x up into a 1x plus a 9x, because when we FOIL'd, those were the 2 middle terms that we combined to get that 10x. If you were to multiply the factored form out. So now we've split it up into 4 terms. So what we need to do is group. We're going to group our first 2 and our last two together. Looking at what's in common with the first two, they both have an x, so let's factor an x out. When we do that, we're left with a 3x plus a 1. We're also going to make sure we carry down our y out front here. A lot of people forget that y, so be careful not to. In our second parentheses, we have a 3 in common, so let's factor a 3 out. And 3 goes into 9x 3x times, and 3 divides into 3 one time. And now notice that our parentheses here match. So we're going to factor the parentheses out of this item and out of this item and take it out with our y out here. That leaves us with a 3x plus 1 with our y. And then we're left with, in the first item, just the x, and in the second item, just our 3. And this final thing that you have right here is your factored form of that particular item.